Hey everyone, the professor here. Well, let's go right to the chart because as we talked about on the Sunday analysis, we are continuing to slide on crude oil. We continue to make a low, a lower high, a low, lower high, and then we are now making a low. So what I want to do is I want to break this down for you. I want to give you some key levels to look for much lower. We talked about it on the Sunday analysis. It's coming to fruition. But again, there's also crude oil news that's going to happen this morning. So I want to prep you for that. So let's get into the analysis. Okay, so we are sitting on the 4-hour chart. Now, the first thing you had to have noticed, right here with this candle now closing below it, we have basically, I'm going to put this here, right? I call it BOS, or we have a break of structure, okay? So when we have a break of structure, also known as a BOS, obviously now we have to continue targeting lower lows, okay? We have to continue targeting lower lows. So this is going to be a key area right here that we are sitting at. So if you can see it over here on the right, it's about 88.51. Okay, now again, I'm going to do most of my analysis on the 4-hour chart, and then we will look for entries on a lower time frame. So understand that once we break structure, the trend has temporarily changed. We have been bearish for a while, but this is, in my opinion, on the 4-hour mark, a confirmation of a break of structure. So as we get deeper into this, right, we are going to look for a couple of things. The first thing I want to do is analyze the next and upcoming key areas. Okay, so right here, this area is going to be a key area because we can see the traffic to the left, and more than likely where price is going to do our next touch, as it did here on two different occasions for support and as it did here for resistance. So we're looking at, if you are at home, we are looking at right around the 8600 level, $86 a barrel. Again, that psychological number of coming down. Now, we do have a little bit of traffic here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and make this a little bit bigger, because as we begin to walk this down even further, you can never ignore the psychological numbers on crude oil. And if you look right here, okay, this was 87. Okay, this was 87, and we had a bounce off that area. So I am going to mark this because if we come back down here, we could very well see another bounce off that area. Okay, so this is the thing about understanding structure and understanding zones. Again, please be reminded, and we talk about this in our group all the time, that zones are never a precise dollar amount. They're an area. Whether you like to do a 5-cent area, a 10-cent area, I like to look at 10 to 15 cents on both sides, both to the top and to the bottom, to give myself some wiggle room. So understand that zones are never a precise line. Okay. So as we kind of get back, let's continue to build this out for what may or may not happen today. So we're seeing a definite bearish movement, right? We definitely understand that. So as we have this bearish movement here, we have to understand that we should be at this point looking to only sell the pullbacks. Okay. So that's what we're looking at from a 1-hour or a 4-hour perspective. Now let's look at the 1-hour perspective. Okay. Again, you can see here, we talk about this all the time, how the 50 moving average works as a great area, especially when the trend is a strong trend here and coming down. Now, one thing I want to show you that sometimes you can keep in mind, and let me get rid of this arrow here. Let me get rid of this arrow here, is when we have these pullbacks, right? I like to kind of measure these pullbacks. Okay. And if you've never done this, take that first pullback. And if you put it to the second pullback, wow, that is pretty close, right? So that begins to show us the strength of what a pullback may look. Is it always precise? Absolutely not. you'll get some minor pullbacks and you'll get some stronger pullbacks. But if you look here at the chart, we're seeing that these pullbacks were pretty close. If we apply this to here, we're seeing here that this pullback, let's move this down a little bit, right, was pretty close. So we're seeing a significant pullback in this particular case. If we look at it points-wise, right, we're looking at about a 16 to 17 cent pullback when these pullbacks do occur. So if we're going to get a pullback in this area, we are probably, ironically, going to kind of come back to this same zone. Like, how ironic is that? That tends to match if we get that same type of pullback, right? Plus or minus 5-10 points, that we are going to come back to that area. That's where you should be sitting for a retest of that zone before selling more crude oil. Now, again, let me warn you that crude oil inventory news happens today at 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Okay, so just have that in case you have any open positions, you understand that. So let's kind of go back into the full chart here and let's kind of begin to evaluate where we are at. So at the same time, what's going to happen is the 50-day moving average continues to come down. It might line up right around here where we're expecting that price to be, right? In addition, right, if we put a Fibonacci level from where this price took off, let's say that that was our low, that lines up also around this 61 to 88.6 area that we constantly talk about. So that is the area there that you should be looking for if you are going to be a seller because of this break of structure, okay? Now, we've already seen the bounce off here. I personally would not be buying here. I would prefer that you wait till price comes back up in these levels and then to test a sell back down to lower levels, okay? And again, you can always keep your stop loss pretty tight. So you might look at a position of something like this if you can get kind of in here somewhere. Okay, I would definitely make it to 127, but you definitely want to ride this back down. So you have about a 2-to-1, right? And you can play around with this, whether you're going to be a 61.8 trader, then that may look something like that for you, right? Or if you want to be a little bit more aggressive or be conservative, I'm sorry, wait till it gets like kind of in between the 61 and the 88, because that lines up pretty well there. And then you can still go back up to this 27, and then you can still bring it right back down to our main target, and that's giving you almost a 2-to-1. So that's what you should be looking for on the sell. Now, I do want to cover what happens if the crude oil news just goes crazy and we break the lower levels. Well, if that's the case, then we are targeting 86 as a dollar, right? So then now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and expand this, and I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these fib levels. If you need to go back, please go back. Right. If we break this, then what you should be looking for is if we break this to the bottom side and we close, remember the key word is always to close, then we're looking at something like this. And then we're looking at possibly price coming right back down to this level. So I think these will be the levels that we play for the rest of the day. This will be our bottom level. This will be our mid level. And this will be our top level. Okay. If we break this area here of about 88.50, then, you know, you're going to be looking at if price just shoots up, right, and closes above 88.60, then you should be looking for price to do the opposite and then to continue to our next level, which is going to be about, I'd say about 89.58, okay, if we break there. But I think based on price action, what I'm seeing that we are probably going to have a pullback in this area and then sell again. Again, there's a lot of conflicting news reports about whether cuts are continuing to happen with OPEC and across the global. The news is going to move the charts in the direction it wants it to move. So again, I still think we're going to be bearish like we have been since Sunday. If we look at the weekly, we're still bearish. So I think this is an opportunity with little risk to look for sell opportunities because we are still under the 50-day moving average. If we close, okay, if we close above the 50-day moving average, if we get a candle to come up here and close above the 50-day moving average, then what does that do? That plays out this scenario here where we're looking for this break and retest, okay, if that's the case. But right now, this is what we're sitting at. We're seeing some form of retracement right now. Again, you should be looking based upon what price has done in these areas here with this pullback, and then with this pullback, that we can expect possibly a similar pullback again in this area right in here. Okay, let me get rid of this one. So that's kind of what we're looking at there. Again, I still think we're bearish. I still think we'll come lower today. But again, that's kind of where I will be sitting. We had some nice points that we caught just a few hours ago. So technically, I'm done with my goals for the trading day. But I wanted to get out this video to you in case you have not had an opportunity to look at crude oil for today. But again, one more time, crude oil news, 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I would love to hear from you, right? If you're getting value on these videos, just go down below to the comment area and just type in the word value. That way I know that you're getting some value on this video. And it also lets me know that you stayed until the very end and I appreciate it. Don't forget to hit that like button. And if you care about someone else, share this video. Maybe it'll teach them something. Maybe it'll show them something. Maybe it'll get them interested into trading. And that's what it's all about. Okay. Finding other streams of income. You should always follow your passion. You should always follow your purpose. Let trading be an extension of that. And if you're a full-time trader, congratulations to you. And if you're working somewhere, congratulations to you, right? So use it as another stream of income. Again, as you saw in my quote earlier at the bottom, and I kind of want to end with this real quick. As you know, faith is very important to me. But if you look at the bottom half there, but whoever gathers money little by little makes it grow. So if you read the word, if you read the Bible, if that is your God that you follow, you know, it tells us in scripture that if you grow money, if you save money, grow money little by little, it will grow, right? So stop trying to always hit a home run in trading. Stop trying to make $100 turn into $10,000. It's not going to happen, right? We have too many false prophets in trading on the internet. So grow your money little by little. As you know, that I should be called 20 pips at a time, right? 20 points at a time, 20 points at a time. Grows your account, keeps you consistent, keeps your mind right, and keeps you excited about coming back the next day versus taking major losses. All right, have a great day. Let me get this video out to you. I'll see you inside of the members area if you are a member. If not, I'll see you inside of our YouTube videos. And don't forget to go down below, share your thoughts, what other videos you want to be seeing, want me to make, and again, type the word value. Have a great day.